Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Monday, SpaceX successfully launched their 76th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1023.
One, ignition, engines full power, and liftoff. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1069, then landed successfully for the 25th time on the drone ship a shortfall of gravitas.
Stage 1 landing, leg deploy.
Also on Monday, SpaceX successfully launched their 77th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Transporter 14.
One, ignition. And liftoff of Falcon 9. Go SpaceX, go Transporter 14.
The booster which launched this mission, B1071, then landed successfully for the 26th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You. On Wednesday, SpaceX successfully launched their 78th Falcon mission of the year with the delayed AX-4 mission.
One, ignition, and liftoff.
The three nations, a new chapter in space.
The booster which launched this mission, B1094, then landed successfully for the second time on the landing pad at landing zone 1.
That John mentioned.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy. Stage 2 FTSS saved.
Also on Wednesday, SpaceX successfully launched their 79th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1016.
One, ignition, engines full power, and liftoff. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1080, then landed successfully for the 20th time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Stage 2 terminal guidance.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
Yesterday, SpaceX successfully launched their 80th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1034.
One. And lift off. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1092, then landed successfully for the fifth time on the drone ship a shortfall of gravitas.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
Also yesterday, SpaceX successfully launched their 81st Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 15-7.
One, ignition, and liftoff of Falcon 9. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1088, then landed successfully for the 8th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
This coming week, we can hopefully expect to see at least a couple of Falcon launches. The first of these, the Starlink 1025 mission, is currently scheduled for Tuesday, July 1st at 6:52 a.m. UTC or 2:52 a.m. EDT. Later in the day on Tuesday, and we should see a customer mission launch. The MTG S1 Sentinel 4A mission is currently scheduled for Tuesday, July 1st at 10:03 p.m. UTC or 6:03 p.m. EDT. SpaceX has won another new contract to launch a payload on Falcon 9. They said Falcon 9 will launch the Space Force's multi-manifest USSF-178 mission, including a new weather system space vehicle for Space Systems Command and Blaze 2 small prototype satellites designed for operational research and development. Heading to Boca Chica, work continues on the construction of the orbital launch pad 2. Cladding has been seen being installed on the pad 2 launch tower. Here's a look at the damage to Massey's test site after the Starship 36 explosion. Here's a closer look at the super-destroyed static fire area of Massey's test site. As they clear up Massey's, a crane was seen tipping over. Here's a look at progress on the housing construction project at Starbase. Here's an aerial view of the construction of the Gigabay at Starbase. There was information about pricing and completion date for the Gigabay SpaceX is building at Starbase. It says we now have a TLDR for the Starbase Gigafactory with a $250 million price tag and a square footage of 700,000 feet with a completion date by the end of 2026. There was some promising news posted about testing vehicles at Starbase after the Starship explosion. It says, looks like static fires cannot wait and SpaceX are now full steam ahead with adapting ships to Pad A. CSI Starbase has been exploring this as an option and tonight we see the proof of it going ahead, Ringwall Transport. A ship transport stand using the road closure to move it down to the launch site. It would take months to rebuild the Massey's test site after Ship 36 unexpectedly exploded, so the next best option is to adapt ships to Orbital Launch Mount A, so looks like 37 will be testing on Pad A. After the Starship explosion, the B18.1 test tank is looking good still. As always, I have to say thanks to Jack Beyer and Cesar Garcia for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.